Hi everyone. I'm back with my live vlog. Sorry, let me take this gun out. So I am back with my live vlog, and today's subject should be pretty fun. It is actually kind of controversial. So it is going to be about men. I'll give you all some preemptive definitions. It's going to be about the fighting game community. The fighting game community, or the FGC, if you've ever seen my Facebook and heard me talk about the FGC, that's what it is. So it's competitive fighting games, Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, BlazBlue, Smash now, anything that you could think of that is a fighter, and it is more than likely competitive. So today's subject is men versus women versus trans. Trans is either transvestite or transsexual. If you don't know the difference, I'll give you the definition, the dictionary definitions. A transvestite, aka a drag queen or crossdresser, is a person, typically a man, who derives pleasure from dressing in clothes appropriate to the opposite sex. A transsexual is a person who emotionally and psychologically feels that they belong to the opposite sex, so they usually get a sex change. Why these things are relevant in the FGC, I will explain that to you. But that will be soon. So, who the hell am I, and why am I, talking about the FGC? If you don't know me, or you don't know any of my relevance into the FGC, I'll explain that. I've played fighting games competitively, I guess you could say, probably since 2004, so it's been about 10 years. I got into traveling to tournaments. I went to the second Aerial Rave, so that was like my first out-of-state tournament. So that was really cool to just see. I didn't play in tournaments until probably about 5 years ago because I was always nervous to play against other people, like real people. I would play against friends or like online or something like that. I started this video blog almost 2 years ago, something like that. And this is the third season. And I'm really excited because I've had people, for this break of time saying, like, where have you been? Like, why haven't you done your video blog? And I explained in the last one, like, where I'd been for the past 6 months. And on the last season, I had a series of three episodes where I interviewed some women in the fighting game community. That was Super Yan, it was Anna Hart, Keats's wife, and Kendra Horton. And, I just talked about, asked them about their experiences and, how they felt being a woman in the FGC. If you would have told me a year ago that I was going to start a group for women of the FGC, I would have laughed, but I have that now. So, we have over 170 members and it's pretty exciting. Brianna, myself, and Kendra all were the original admins. And we now have Lynette, who is also an admin, and she's awesome. And I mean, it's been awesome. It's been really exciting. And when the group first started, there was a lot of turbulence, and like a lot of guys were talking crap about us and making it seem like we just wanted the group to talk about boys and all this other weird stuff. So I went on the On Blast show earlier this year, probably like February. It was like right before final round. And I basically corrected all of the misconceptions about my specific group and, told them what we weren't and what we were. And, that the group is really just a bonding experience for the women of the FGC to get to know each other, make friends, talk about games, talk about what tournaments they're going to next, just basic things. And shout outs to James Fink because he is the host of the On Blast show. If you have never watched it, it's great. It comes on every Tuesday. And yeah, and he was very pleasant to me and, listened, and it was an awesome dialogue. I'm sure, I don't remember exactly the episode I was on, but I'm sure you can look it up. It was earlier then. And I pretty much told you know, everyone listening or watching, that if they had anything to say to me about my group or about any of the women in the group, that they could meet me at Final Round and talk to me in person, but no one ever did. So, you know, it's just that, it's that internet bully thing, which I will get into. So that's my brief introduction. So I'm going to be looking down and reading this, because I spent like 2 hours writing this outline for this specific blog, because it is a very sensitive subject, and, you know, people take these things very seriously, you know. And this is a disclaimer. This vlog is in no way, shape, or form to promote hate, homophobia, bigotry, or anything of the sort. It is not meant to create a wedge between any gender or race in any way, shape, or form. It is meant to provoke honest thought and discussion regarding human nature. In short, this is simply my personal observation on the culture in the FGC. So, to start off, in my personal opinion, start off like this. I sent a question to a bunch of players that I know in the FGC, regardless of whether I know them personally or just know them because they're famous in the FGC. And I got a lot of replies from it, actually. I was surprised how many people replied to me. It was really exciting. And they were generally very positive. Like, no one was offended. I was very happy of that. People really just read it and understood, you know, and gave me their opinion. And so this is the question that I sent to them. In my opinion, the FGC consists of people within these following categories. A, people that only come for fighting games. B, people that come for fighting games and the social aspect of the scene. And C, people that come with friends or boyfriend or girlfriend to meet people or just basically hang out with probably their friends that do play fighting games. These people in the FGC include men, transvestites or transsexuals, and women. And the reason why I separated those categories is because of this. I noticed a hierarchy in the categories that, in most cases, it seems that people who are trans still get more respect than natural-born women in the community. Have you noticed this? If so, why do you think this is? Don't care? That's cool, too. But I'm just interested in what people think. That was what I sent all of the players. I'm not going to name any names, but I will just describe them as player female, player male, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So the responses that I got to these questions are as follows. Player one, trans. This was a quote, and these were all, I was given permission for all of these, so I'm not just like rattling off. Player one, trans. Men don't accept trans women as women. It's about transphobia, mass under props. Asian women aren't put on a pedestal for props. They're basically viewed as objects and sidekicks. They achieve attention by racial fetishes, but do you really envy that, really? That was in response to me saying that I also thought that the main women in the community, if they get any attention at all, it is Asian women. You know, regardless of whether they play or not, that wasn't to, you know, separate any, you know, create a wedge. Like I said earlier, it was just a general observation. Everyone doesn't do it. And I will say that, you know, to the end, every man in the community does not do this. It is a very finite group of people. I think it has a lot to do with stream monsters. It has a lot to do with the internet, Kappa, you know, all of these things, YouTube, you know, all of this stuff, you know, blogs, various blogs, you know, stuff like my blog. And so I found that very interesting, and I had a really awesome conversation with this first player, and it was like a really long conversation, and she got really in depth with me and, you know, just told me a bunch of stuff from her perspective, and I really appreciate it. It opened my eyes to a lot of different things. Player two, trans. To be honest, I've never noticed a difference in the way that we're treated. What I can say that I have noticed is that the two main factors always come up when trans or women are concerned in gaming. It is about how we look, if we are attractive to a certain extent, and the level that we're playing at. being someone who understands the games more than most men, I can GG's the most average player. This specific player is actually a really good player, and she was very good at some older Capcom games, and it was definitely interesting to see her perspective of that, which I agreed with that also. Player three, this was just a female. As for transvestites or transsexuals, players like Ricky Ortiz, Ricky Ortiz's name will probably be the only name that I mention just straight out, because Ricky was not one of the people that I interviewed, and I don't know Ricky personally. I would have loved to interview Ricky, but I didn't have any way to just contact him without being awkward or like feeling, you know, uncomfortable, or him feeling uncomfortable, I mean. Okay, I'll repeat that. As for transvestites or transsexuals, players like Ricky Ortiz have respect because, quite frankly, he has earned it, which I agree. He's a phenomenal player, and I think because of this, he gains more support. This is a great example of how great players who place constantly will get the support of those within the FGC. However, I do agree that overall, they do receive better acceptance than women, but I don't have a solid proof of that. It's just the comments I see here and there. I mean, some people respect me, some people don't. Shrug. Same goes for blank. She mentioned another player that I won't say their name. Or other female players. And this whole thing about they have to win Evo to get my respect is a stupid argument, because there are plenty of male players who haven't ever won Evo or any other tournament, in my personal opinion. She didn't say that, but I just added that in. Or haven't won Evo, and they have respect. I fucking hate that argument. It's so stupid, and I don't understand why any woman would bring it up, if you know what I mean. You know, and that I do agree with that, because I do feel like a lot of women get flustered by the way that trolls treat them in the community, or like, some, you know, scummy, stupid dudes in the community. And it is hard for a girl coming in who has no start off point. She plays at home maybe, or plays online or something like that. I was lucky enough that my community is awesome. And I can say that like 10 times over, the Chicago FGC is probably one of the best communities in the country. Like, I've been in it since 2004. No one has ever like really given me a hard time. People would show me how to play. They would talk to me. They would ask me if I wanted to learn a new game. They, you know, treated me like I was a human being and didn't treat me like I was a girl playing a game. I just started playing Arcade Stick probably a year ago, or learning Arcade Stick, I should say. And still, even, you know, people helping me, or, you know, asking me if I wanted to learn different tech or whatever, you know, very supportive. Didn't matter that I was a girl. It was just like, you know, oh, you're here to play Persona, whatever, let's play. You know, it was never a stigma. And it feels like when I go out of state, it's definitely this almost arrogance of some guys, because they just assume you're either there to just find dudes to have sex with, or you're there to, like, I don't know, you're there with your boyfriend, or you're not actually there to just, like, play fighting games. Whether you play competitively or not, I feel like even if you're not good and you just enjoy playing it, that's okay, too. Some people have other stuff to do in their lives that don't have to do with the FGC. And it seems like some people that get so invested in this lifestyle forget that. So moving on to the males that I interviewed. Player four, male. I haven't noticed this hierarchy actually, but it's probably because I'm not one of those, I'm not in one of those degenerated groups. I think that the FGC has come a long way in the past few years when it comes to accepting others, and maybe that has blinded me. I remember when blank player was a total outcast, and when people used to snicker at Ricky. I think that those days are behind us now, which is a good thing. As far as the treatment of women is concerned, I feel that it's isolated to a few assholes in the community, people whose social skills haven't progressed past the days of the He-Man Woman Haters Club and the No Girls Allowed signs. This is more of a societal thing than the FGC thing, though, because those assholes exist in all facets of society. I completely agree with this, and I really, really enjoyed that response. And someone else, when I posted this question in the Chicago fighting game community group, someone else did also mention that it's everywhere in the world. It is, but personally, I feel that harmoniously within the FGC, players that are gay or androgynous or transsexual, transgender, any of that category, definitely really get accepted. And it's really refreshing that people are not bashing, you know, like gay bashing and all of that. Whereas in the real world, it is less accepted. Obviously, the past, 7-8 years, it has become, you know, more potent, or it's become more noticeable to see, you know, gay, lesbian couples, all that, gay marriage. It's obviously been a big thing, but they have had to fight for that acceptance. And I'm sure there was a time for that in the FGC, but seeing it now, I agree with this player that it has really progressed and people just openly accept them. And our fans, you know, how many fans does Ricky have? Tons. Like, it's just, you know, generally accepted, which I think is great. But it, at a cost, I feel like it does tend to, you know, the women do tend to get treated still just like we're not as good, even as a trans player. Player 5, male, local. I have noticed this, but the community is filled with a bunch of man children, so you can't really expect them to have much on the ball, which I have also said that. And again, this isn't every guy in the FGC. It is a group of men that are socially awkward and probably don't know how to talk to women in real life, and so they come to this fairy tale land called the FGC, and they think that they can say and do whatever they want and act however they want. To, you know, the girls are still a small population that's recognized, or female players, I should say, is still a small population, but it is, you know, it's definitely noticeable, and it's unfortunate that those guys just choose to be immature versus just playing, you know. Player 4, male, West Coast. That people are less upfront about, he was referring to a player, a trans player that he knows. People are much less upfront about what they say about her because they feel that it's a touchy subject. So they probably feel it's politically incorrect to talk about her because they don't want to hurt her feelings. But they still talk openly about her when she's not around. So again, I don't think that it's that they have more respect or whatever for trans players. It's just that people aren't as upfront about it, about how they feel in regards to, like, I guess, women, men, and trans players in the community. Player 6, female, West Coast. Yeah, I have definitely noticed that. I kind of see it similar to how gay people are viewed in places like the Philippines. Yeah, people are socially allowed to embrace their sexuality and be openly gay without being attacked on the street, but they're not respected. They're actually treated as a sideshow, like some novelty. So while they benefit from the safety that most women don't, they are not respected. Ricky is respected because he's very good at Street Fighter. And KO is because she's legit famous in Japan and really pretty. But if you're a regular trans person, you get shit on. People throw up the word trap around, and people throw the word trap around like it's not supposed to be offensive. And especially with poison being added to the current Street Fighter, people act even more now like being trans is some kind of fetish novelty, basically. It is really fascinating because obviously poison has been around for a very long time. And, you know, it that Poison, along with Bridget, are probably the two most popular trans characters that I can think of. And they're both good, and people really love both of those characters. So maybe that also fed into the general just like acceptance of people being different from you, and you just needing to get over that and play games. And if they beat you, then you'll just be salty, and you just have to hold that. And this is the last player. Player 7, male. As far as women in the FGC, that's a long time conflict. I'll use this analogy to help get my point across. It's like when men who are sports athletes view most women who try to get to enter their world as groupies, just looking to be seen or gain notoriety, etc., etc. Now, this, of course, isn't true for all, but it is a generalization, no doubt. And I really liked that analogy to like sports, because obviously a lot of people do view competitive fighting games as a sport. It takes a skill, it takes a lot of your time, you train, it's a sport to me. I think that is very true, and a lot of women in the FGC, regardless of whether they're playing, even if they are playing, a lot of the time still get categorized as groupies. I mean, I've been called tons of things, but in my community, no. Traveling to stuff, sure, people will say messed up stuff, but it's just very fascinating to, see all of that play out. So let's talk about this hierarchy. The hierarchy was what I placed in these categories. The interviews are over. So those were all of the players that or those were all of the players that gave me responses where they had an opinion on it. Some players said that they didn't notice it, or some players said that if they had, it wasn't really important to them. And I know that I mentioned like West Coast and all of that. I did email some East Coast players, but none of them replied to me. So, who knows? This is the hierarchy that I was talking about. Players that get respect, top players, men. Trans players, top or good. Trans players are top, sorry, trans players, top or good. Ones that don't get respect, women at any level. And throughout my conversation with one of the players who was trans, she was telling me about that it wasn't any different, and just kind of like opened up a portion of her life to me and explained to me that, like showed me links to videos and showed me like her Ask FM, page. And she was like, it isn't any different. We still get these kind of creepy, like weird responses. It's just maybe that some people are more undercover about it. Maybe undercover in person. They just wait until they control the internet. Whereas women, I think, get it in person on the internet. Like, no matter what, it's a very rare occurrence that you come across it, and it's just a regular interaction. If you're not getting hit on or something like that, which is nothing wrong with like flirting and stuff at tournaments, tons of people do it, but you shouldn't treat every girl at a tournament like she's trying to come and just meet dudes. There are girls that do that, but it isn't all girls, and that is an unfortunate generalization. Women don't generalize guys in terms of, oh, well, all of you all are just here to cheer for this one player at the end. Generally, if you're coming to the tournament, you think you have some kind of chance if you're playing. Usually, if not, then you're just coming to tournaments just for the atmosphere, like I said earlier. So this is the last portion of my little outline, and this was something that I wrote personally. This wasn't a something that anyone told me in one of the interviews or anything like that. It seems to definitely be a thing of worship with the hierarchy that I named. It seems to be a thing of worship. I totally agree that trans are not all good players. But that they have, the ones that are good have grinded and have made a name for themselves because they have worked hard for it. So I'm not trying to take away any of their accomplishments, whether they're transgender, whatever, born women, men, anything like that. That's not what I'm trying to do. This is really just a social commentary on things that I've noticed over time from going to tournaments and, you know, seeing the community and reading about the community. My problem is the general hate towards women being involved in the community simply because they are women and nothing else. I understand it's not every man in the community, and that the people, the Stream Monsters, Kappa Warriors, it's not the same as real life judgment, but it happens, it still happens at the same time in person. If you are a woman and you're not small or cute or Asian, if you're not small, cute, and Asian, some of the times, it seems to turn into one of the following. You're at a tournament with your boyfriend, you're a pro-ho, or you don't know what you're doing, video game-wise. It's a complex issue that obviously cannot be solved overnight, but it's definitely something that I've noticed over time. Luckily, like I said, and I will repeat this, luckily the Chicago scene doesn't really have this. Mostly, everyone has been welcoming and awesome to me over the years, but it still exists. I'm not going to say that every player in Chicago is not a scumbag. There are scumbags everywhere. That's the world. But in my specific community, I have definitely, you know, been accepted, and people don't treat me like I'm just a girl. You know, they treat me like, oh, you're going to play Persona or what, you know, like that type of stuff. Two players that don't know each other reference the same trans objectification, excuse me, equating the transsexual fetish to the fact that characters in fighting games like Poison, Bridget, Leo from Tekken, Naoto from Persona 4 Arena, or Persona 4, etc., being that since these characters are good, it becomes related to an almost erotic infatuation. Because there are definitely a ton of straight male players that, like, slobber over Ricky and slobber over KO Police and, like, all of these other people that are obviously, well, maybe they're not obviously trans, but people, I mean, it is obviously rumored that they are men or were born men or whatever, you know, and it's just really interesting. And then the only girl that I can think of that has received that type of response is Kayane, you know, and she is small and Asian and French. So, you know, not to say that that proves my point, but she is just one player, but, you know, she is also a very good player, and that is not to take anything away from her. All of these people that are in the top that I have mentioned have worked hard for what they have done, regardless of what their gender is, what their sexuality is, any of that. They've worked for it, and I understand that. But it's just unfortunate that the community has chosen as a whole to just kind of like have these weird, like, preferential treatment things, you know, because I wonder what it would be like if a natural born woman did get top 8 at Evo in anything, you know, that wasn't an all female tournament or all something tournament. It would be very fascinating to see that. You know, it's definitely a sticky subject, and I hope that everyone took something from this, and I hope that you all have a lot of questions, because I'm very interested to see what everyone's reception is of this vlog. So I'll open it up to the Q&A portion, because that's all of my 2-hour written outline. So yeah, you all can shoot me those questions in the chat. You can send me questions on Facebook, whatever. So I'm here. Well, for people that, while I'm waiting for questions, for people that didn't, watch the last one, I wasn't doing my blog for like the past 6 months because I was traveling a lot and, just, you know, doing a bunch of different stuff and had a good time and, you know, learned a lot about people, learned a lot about, you know, just the world and, you know, met a lot more people. So that's where I've been, and it's been pretty fun. I'm really excited for these questions, guys. Slevin, 786 says, people are always jerks. Can't let it faze you. Show up and show out. Oh, I agree with that. It's, you know, me personally, it doesn't bother me, but I know a lot of the girls that I've met over the years, if they have not developed a tough skin, then, you know, it will still bother them, regardless of whether they travel to tournaments or they don't travel to tournaments. It is still something that, you know, gets to them. And it's understandable because some of the things the dudes say are ugly. You know, it's just really unfortunate. Is really unfortunate. I'm waiting for questions, guys. Let's see. Green Lantern 99 asked, what's the solution, if any? You know, when I was on the Unblast show, they kind of asked me the same question, and it's hard to even come up with like a real solution to this issue. I definitely don't think that anyone should be marginalized or treated differently, regardless of whether they're trans or male or female. But that's in a perfect world. We're talking about the FGC and the real world outside of the FGC. You know, like with one of the players said, I definitely think that it has gotten better over the years, but not necessarily for women. Like, there's been progression with the way some women are treated in the FGC, but in general, it still tends to be objects. Unless they're very well known, you know, no one really treats a lot of the women with respect. Unfortunately, you just get those assumptions, especially online. And I know that a lot of girls tend to be internet warriors, and they, you know, they have a lot of experience dealing with, you know, crappy dudes saying messed up shit to them online. But on the same token, men get, you know, called racial slurs and, you know, all kind of terrible stuff online too. So it's not just a specific thing with the online stuff. And women are emotional and women are sensitive, and not to say that, you know, females should be catered to in the FGC. That's not what I'm saying at all. But, you know, we shouldn't just be blatantly placed into one of these miscellaneous categories that guys feel like is for us. Let's see. So, No Alias 16 says, kind of how, oh wait, crazy that the people who have the women or trans problem are the people asking women or trans how to solve the problem that they obviously have. Kind of how racist people asked black people, well, how do we treat you guys better? You know, I don't think that previous question was meant to like really cause any type of anxiety or like an argument. I think it was just kind of a curious question. It's something that should be talked about, and that's why I'm talking about it, because I'm not afraid of what people think, what people are going to say, like any type of backlash that I may get. It doesn't bother me. I'm open to any questions that people have to ask me. So, you know, have at it. And, yeah, while I'm still waiting for questions, I hope you guys enjoyed this subject. And if you would like me to do more social commentary pieces on the FGC, I definitely will. But, I mean, I like talking about the FGC because it's my community and I do love it. It's just, you know, those couple of douchebags make it hard for some people. And at the end of the day, I think you just kind of have to ignore them, you know, until there's like a massive stand to, you know, or unless you beat them. And sometimes even if you beat dudes, some of these types of dudes won't have like any change. Slevin 786 says, what will get these niggas to stop smelling in the FGC? Yeah, that's really funny. The smell is really bad. It's sometimes can be worse than anime conventions, but not by a long shot. And that was one thing I thought was very funny at UFGTX this year, that they set up small deodorants and like hand sanitizer at all of the stations. And hopefully people took those deodorants and used them because I don't understand not having basic hygiene. If no one else has any questions for me, then I'm just going to wrap it up. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you don't, if you come up with a question later and you didn't get a chance to ask me here, you can ask me on Facebook. My name is Melanie Shaw on Facebook. Or you can ask me on my ask.fm, which is Moxie Peaches, at Moxie Peaches. I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, I'm on all of those under Moxie Peaches. So, yeah. Oh, okay, I have a question. No Alias 16 says, have an idea where the FGC's infatuation with Asian women may come from.
Not the FGC. I think that's the United States.
Yeah, I think that's just the United States. That was Kevin, the producer, over here. It is just general. Like, you know, I think it's just a general sexual infatuation with Asian women. And the FGC and the anime communities, anime conventions, all that, it is very prominent because, I mean, video games come from Japan. The anime comes from Japan. And, you know, the general, you know, Asian woman, image is usually gotten from personalities in anime or from, you know, something fictional. And a lot of it, I think, also just comes from dudes that don't really know how to approach anyone. They just kind of fetishize this one type of female. I mean, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with Asian girls. Nothing at all. I have plenty of Asian female friends. So it's just one of those things that I think is societal based. Drop Them 21 says, do the males of the FGC take it harder when they lose to a girl? Some of them do, some of them don't. When I played TVC, I had a guy, there's a place here called Gameworks, and I was playing TVC at the cab that they had, and this guy sat down next to me, and I bodied him, and then he, like, didn't even say anything. He just got up and walked away, and I thought that was hilarious. But then at UFGT, this past year, I went 0-2, it went like down to the wire with Blaze Blue, and, the guy who I was playing, it was a mirror match. We both were playing Noelle, and I hadn't played the game in months. I just wanted to play something. And, cause it was my local tourney, and, he was like really excited. Like he was so happy. He was obviously happy that he won, but he was very respectful. Like when I stood up, he shook my hand. He asked me for my PSN and like my Twitter name and like started following me on Twitter. It was like really awesome. And I had never experienced that before. I thought it was really respectful that he didn't just treat me like a girl, but just like a player. Slevin786 says, what can be done to get more women to compete in the FGC? You know, like I said earlier, a lot of girls just play at home or online or with their friends or whatever. And I think tournaments is where you get the real view of the FGC. The internet is kind of like this weird cesspool of like shitty people that hide behind the veil of the internet and say fucked up stuff. But, you know, I think a lot of girls don't go to tournaments, not just because traveling to a lot of tournaments is expensive, or not that they don't have the dedication. I think it's just the innate fear of dealing with guys, the crappy guys in the community that maybe, you know, them getting hollered at all weekend, or if they wear makeup and dress up cute, then they're called a whore. So, I mean, you know, anything like that. If you're hanging out with your friends, you're clearly sleeping with all of them, that kind of thing. And I think that a lot of girls in the community do have that serious fear. I don't. And I luckily have met other girls that do frequently travel to tournaments. Kendra travels to a lot. She goes to more tournaments than I do. I've traveled to definitely more Midwest tournaments, but, you know, and Evo. But, yeah, I've never been to an East Coast tournament or any of that. I would love to, but, you know, time and money, it's those things. And then there were some other questions scrolled up that somebody asked.
We should just have some of these people here.
Right. These comments, though. Like, oh, shoot. Okay, Drop Them 21 asked, what are some of the stereotypes associated with females when it comes to competitive gaming? Well, yeah, I mean, I said that earlier. It is that you're there to just meet dudes and not play. You're a whore or a groupie. If you are there to play, you don't even know what you're doing. Let's see. Okay. T Bobo. Scroll up a little bit. Sorry. T Bobo says, honestly, I've just gotten into the FGC. Oh, it scrolled down. Sorry. That's cool.
Because of the show this
week. Yeah. Honestly, I have just gotten into the FGC due to the show, but I've seen three of the same things like this in the cosplay community. I know it's not overnight. I know it's not an overnight thing, but we have to make a plan to stop it. Where do you think we should start? I know I shut it down. I shut down when I see it. You know, the place to start, it's kind of like things, massive change like that is something that needs to involve everyone, and it involves awareness. And I just doubt that everyone would really care about that, because obviously everyone goes to tournaments for fighting games. That is the point. That's what brings us all together. And you know, the social aspect is definitely secondary. I completely believe that. But, you know, the social aspect is also very big, because people, you know, have all Reddit and, you know, all this kind of stuff. But, I mean, the solution would have to start with people being aware of it first and wanting to do something about it, because the FGC is mostly male. You know, it has always been mostly male. It has just recently gotten more women. Do you think they should make a separate tourney for ladies again? At Evo, I'm assuming. I think that would be cool. You know, it would definitely give girls a chance to, like, play against each other. But I honestly don't think a lot of the girls that play competitive games would want that type of favoritism. I think they just want to play and beat other players. I don't think they want to just play against other girls who, you know, just happen to be girls. Like, regardless of whether they're good or not, and they can be dudes. But, you know, I just don't think that girls will want that type of favoritism. Let's see. Do you think the gaming community impacts non-gaming communities? Why or why not? I mean, nerd culture has become really popular over the years, so, you know, there's that. It's definitely, there have been tons, you know, WCG Gamer and that other show that was on Sci-Fi and the TNT, the biggest King of the Nerds or whatever. I mean, nerd culture has definitely become more popular, but I don't think the fighting game community really affects too much. The only time they talk about the FGC is if some douchebag writes something that they don't know about that happened at a tournament on Kotaku. That's the only time I've ever seen the FGC referenced in real life. So, no, I don't think it affects it. Yeah, so, yeah, I think that's about it. We have been on about an hour, or about 40 minutes, and I hope you guys have enjoyed it, and, you know, tell your friends, and, you know, the archive will be up this week, hopefully, and if it's not, then I will post it next week, and tag all your friends, and share it, and all that awesome stuff. If you have any more questions, you can send them to my Ask FM, or Facebook, or Twitter, whatever. So, thanks. When's Marvel?
That's always a good question.
Yeah, that is always a good question. I don't know. I wish it was right now. Bye, everybody. Thank you. Thank you.